Right, Karen. I'm an associate professor in UPSE. What happened is I'm actually a tenured professor. So when I joined the Department of Finance, parang pinahiram lang ako ng UP. So naka-assign lang ako doon. So when I left DOF, automatically babalik ako sa UP.
Okay, so it was a controversial resignation, but you did say that there was, it was because of a difference in policy. So now you can speak freely, right? President Marcos Jr. says it's the perfect time, he says, to lift the cap on rice. What are your thoughts on that? Was it ever even a good time?
Similar to what I've said before, I think the price cap was not the best strategy to address the increasing price of rice last month when it was implemented, because it has negative consequences to the market and even to the perception of the business sector. So I am very happy that it has been finally lifted and that hopefully moving forward, the government would be more mindful in terms of adopting policies and sending signals to the market and the private sector.
Okay, but what was the effect of that 1 month that we had a price cap? There must be an effect. Now that it's lifted, what's the consequence of that 1 month?
Yeah, so we've seen that when the government implemented the price cap, we've seen a proliferation of adulterated rice in the market. And that's understandable because the sellers would be expecting losses because they bought the price at a higher price and now they're forced to sell at a lower price. Then one of the strategy would be to mix the quality of rice. So we've seen poor quality of rice mixed with good quality so that they can recover the cost of the rice that they're selling. That's one. Second is that we've also witnessed rationing. There are caps in terms of the volume of rice that you can buy. Of course, we've seen people hoarding rice, and that's what they've been doing, right? They've been raiding warehouses because people are hoarding, and the reason why they're hoarding is, again, when they bought the rice, that's much higher than what is being asked of them to sell at the level of the price cap. So those things happen in that month. And the thing is, a price cap will only be effective if the government really has the capacity to enforce it. And how many sellers do we need to monitor all over the country to make sure that the price ceiling is really enforced? So it's kind of impossible to really implement seriously. So even if there was a price cap, we still saw the price of rice higher than the price cap. So that alone would tell us that it's an ineffective policy. What made it worse is that because of the policy, then the government has to give assistance to sellers when we could have just given targeted assistance to households who are having a hard time affording rice.
That's quite interesting. So now that the president has lifted the price cap, what are you seeing in the market? Or what do you think will happen? At one point, we saw 45 pesos per kilo. Now that it's lifted and harvest season is coming and supposedly we have a bigger buffer stock, do you believe there will be a dramatic change in the price?
There might be some decrease in the price of rice. We're seeing that because of the increase in the domestic supply of rice, which is cheaper than the global price of rice. So we hope to see that. And hopefully with the increase in the domestic supply, the government has to make sure that the NFA has sufficient buffer stock. Because if the NFA has sufficient buffer stock, then we can just flood the market with the domestic rice and not worry about the significant impact of the global price of rice in the market. Mm-hmm. But then again, thinking long term, I think the government has to learn from this experience. No? The reason why the price of rice increases because of the behavior at the international level. Countries expecting lower rice production because of climate change. So thinking long term, I think it's very important that the government make the rice sector more resilient to make sure that we have stable local production and to make sure that the rice that we are producing are more resilient. We're producing it more efficiently by providing the appropriate infrastructure. So it's not just a short term approach in addressing rice, but making sure that we have sufficient supply, not just rice production, but using the tariff as a tool to lower the tariff rate when needed to make sure that we have lower, more accessible rice in the market.
Okay. Now, ideally, the rice tariffication law was supposed to open the market so we'd have cheaper rice. That was the intention, right? So let's take out the long-term planning first. What could the president, what could he have done instead of the price cap that could have managed the prices?
Yeah, so one alternative that economists are suggesting was to lower the tariff on rice because currently the tariff is, I think, around 35%. So there was a suggestion to lower this at 10% or to even
Put it
suspend
to
it
zero.
temporarily. Yeah, so lower tariff on imported rice would mean lower price at the local level.